risen in the darkness for the upright of heart. The Lord is generous, merciful, and just. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. This Mass, as we continue our celebrations of the Epiphany season, is offered for Brother Harold Palmer. Brother Harold, as I think I've said to you before, is a hermit living in the wilds of the Northumbrian countryside at Shepherd's Law, where over the last 50 years he has built himself a remarkable hermitage with a remarkable prayerful ministry at the heart of the church. Brother Harold is far from well at the moment and being treated in hospital. So we pray for him, we pray for his doctors and nurses, and we pray for all those whose lives are caught up with the witness of his praying hermitage. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we ask, Almighty God, that the nativity of the Saviour of the world, made known by the guidance of a star, may be revealed ever more fully to our minds. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
First letter of St. John. Who can overcome the world? Only the man who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus Christ, who came by water and blood. Not with water only, but with water and blood, with the Spirit as another witness, since the Spirit is the truth. So that there are three witnesses, the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And all three of them agree. We accept the testimony of human witnesses, but God's testimony is much greater. And this is God's testimony, given as evidence for his Son. Everybody who believes in the Son of God has this testimony inside him, and anyone who will not believe God is making God out to be a liar, because he has not trusted the testimony God has given about his Son. This is the testimony. God has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. Anyone who has the Son has life. Anyone who does not have the Son does not have life. I have written all this to you so that you who believe in the name of the Son of God may be sure that you have eternal life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Oh, praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Oh, praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Zion, praise your God. He has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed the children within you.
Oh, praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He established peace on your borders. He feeds you with finest wheat. He sends out his word to the earth and swiftly runs his command.
Oh, praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He makes his word known to Jacob, to Israel, his laws and decrees. He has not dealt thus with other nations. He has not taught them his decrees.
Oh, praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Glory to you, O Christ. Proclaim to the pagans. Glory to you, O Christ, believed in by the world. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus was in one of the towns when a man appeared covered with leprosy. Seeing Jesus, he fell on his face and implored him. "Sir," he said, "if you want to, you can cure me." Jesus stretched out his hand, touched him and said, "Of course I want to. Be cured." And the leprosy left him at once. He ordered him to tell no one, but go and show yourself to the priest and make the offering for your healing as Moses prescribed it, as evidence for them. His reputation continued to grow, and large crowds would gather to hear him and to have their sickness cured, but he would always go off to some place where he could be alone and pray. The Gospel of the Lord.
Yes.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Brethren, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at thy hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Receive with favour, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these holy mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. this, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. Jesus, I believe you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you in Holy Communion now, at least come spiritually into my heart. As if you have already come to me, I embrace you and join myself wholly to you. Do not allow me to distance myself from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who touch us through our partaking of your sacrament, work, we pray, the effects of its power in our hearts, that we may be made fit to receive your gift through this very gift itself. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. Mother of our Saviour, Saint Joseph, Caspar, Melchior, Balthazar, Saint John the Evangelist. Pray for us.